गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, क्लास 12th, चैप्टर नंबर 6, एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ डेरिवेटिव, लेक्चर 2, होमवर्क एंड लेक्चर 3. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट एक्सरसाइज 6.2. ऑल्सो आई विल डिस्कस सम ऑफ द क्वेश्चंस गिवन इन होमवर्क. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद एक्सरसाइज 6.2, क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 देयर वर 5 पार्ट्स, सो आई एम गोना गो डिस्कस ओनली 2 ऑफ देम. लेट अस डिस्कस बी पार्ट ऑफ इट. इन दिस द फंक्शन इज गिवन एज 10 minus 6x minus 2x square. What we have to calculate the intervals in which the following functions are strictly increasing or decreasing, right? So we know that first of all we are going to differentiate the function. We get the differentiation of 10 will be 0, of minus 6 it will be minus of 6, and minus 2x square it will be 4x. Taking minus 2 common, we have 3 plus 2x inside the bracket. Now to find the critical point at which your function differentiation would be 0, you will equate it to 0. Equating it to 0, we get the value of x. From here, we get 3 plus 2x as equal to 0, hence x is equal to minus 3 by 2. We will plot this on number line. So suppose this is our number line. So, plotting minus 3 by 2 on it, it divides the number line into two disjoint intervals. The first interval is minus infinity to minus of 3 by 2 in the open intervals, and the another will be minus 3 by 2 to infinity. Now, we are going to form a table in which we will be writing the intervals, the value of f dash x, whether it is positive or negative, and the nature of the function, whether it is strictly increasing or decreasing, right? So let us just form the table. So here is the table. In the first column, we will write intervals. So we have two intervals. One is minus infinity comma minus 3 by 2 in the open intervals. The second one is minus 3 by 2 to infinity. Now in the second column, we're going to write f dash x. Right, so here we will write whether less than 0 or greater than 0 in the respective places. Here in the third column we are going to write nature of the function, whether strictly increasing or decreasing. Now from minus infinity to minus 3 divided by 2, if we take any value in between this, let us suppose we take minus 2. Okay, if we take x as minus 2, putting it in the f dash x, which was actually minus 2 into 3 plus 2x. If we put minus 2, just to see, we will get 2 into 3 minus of 4. Solving it, we get the answer as minus minus will become positive, right? So you're going to get an answer which is positive greater than 0. So here we will write greater than 0. Hence the nature of the function is strictly increasing. Now, similar way we are going to do for the second interval. Suppose we take x value as, from the values we have to take minus 3 by 2 to infinity. Let us suppose I take 1. Putting this in the function f dash x, we get minus 2 into 3 plus 2. You see, you are going to get a negative answer which is less than 0. So here you are going to write less than 0 and the function is strictly decreasing. So this is how you are going to write and form the table in these questions. So let us discuss one more part. Question number 6th, E part. In E part, f of x is given as x plus 1 whole cube into x minus 3 whole cube. Considering these as u and we will apply product rule here. So let us find the derivative of it. First function as it is, x plus 1 to the power 3 as it is. Differentiation of x minus 3 to the power 3 will be 3 into x minus 3 to the power 2. And differentiation of x minus 3, you know it will be 1. Plus x minus 3 whole cube as it is. Differentiation of x plus 1 whole to the power 3. It will be 3 x plus 1 to the power 2. Now, just to see what we have common, x plus 1 whole square is common. And the another term 3 is common. One more thing, x minus 3 whole square is common. If we take this common, what we are left with? We are left with x plus 1 plus x minus 3. Solving it, we get 3 multiplied with x plus 1 whole square, x minus 3 whole square into एक्स प्लस एक्स विल बी टू एक्स एंड वन माइनस थ्री विल बी माइनस ऑफ टू. सो इफ यू टेक टू कॉमन, जस्ट सी वी हैव थ्री इंटू टू विल बी सिक्स, एक्स प्लस वन होल स्क्वायर, एक्स माइनस थ्री होल स्क्वायर इंटू एक्स माइनस वन. Now for critical point, putting f dash x as equal to 0, we get three values of x. The first one is minus 1, the second is 3, and the third one is 1. So plotting these on the number line, we can check how many intervals we get, and in the intervals we can check the nature of the function, whether strictly increasing or decreasing. So let us just plot the points on the number line. Now plotting them on the number line, we had to plot minus 1, 1 and 3. Just to see, the number line is divided into parts. The first one, which is from minus infinity to minus 1. The second is minus 1 to 1. The third is 1 to 3. And the fourth is 3 to infinity. Now as we did in the previous part, that in between the intervals, we're going to pick any value. And we'll be placing in our first order derivative of the function. We'll see whether it is less than 0 or greater than 0. Based on which you're going to write whether the function is strictly increasing or decreasing. Let us just check for two intervals. The others you can complete in your homework part. So just to see, minus infinity to minus 1. The derivative we have written here, f dash x. So let us take any value. Suppose we take minus 2. Just to see, we will get 6 into minus 2 plus 1 whole square, minus 2 minus 3 whole square, minus 2 minus 1. So just to see, 6 multiplied with, you know this is going to give you a positive answer. This also will give you positive answer. From this you are going to get a negative answer, right? So the total at last you are going to get a negative number in the answer, which is less than 0. Hence in the interval from minus infinity to minus 1, the function value is decreasing, right? So hence it is a strictly decreasing function. Similarly, you can check between minus 1 to 1, 1 to 3 and 3 to infinity and form out your table. Let us go to another question now. Let us now discuss question number 10. In this it is asked, we have to prove that the logarithmic function is increasing on the interval 0, infinity. Right, so the function is log of x. When you differentiate it, what do you get? 1 by x. Now, we know that see, 0 is not included, it's an open interval. All the values we have for x are greater than 0. So when x is greater than 0, you know, 1 divided by x will also be greater than 0. Hence, the value of f dash x will always be positive. Clear? Hence, we can say that logarithmic function is increasing in the interval 0, infinity. Let us go to the next question now. The next question is question number 11. In which it is asked, we have to prove that the function given by f of x equals x square minus x plus 1 is neither strictly increasing nor decreasing on the interval minus 1 to 1. So first of all, we'll differentiate it. What do we get? F dash x equals 2x minus 1. Putting it as equal to 0, we get the value of x as half. Correct? Now we will plot this number on number line. So suppose this is your number line, or let us take it a proper one. So suppose this is our number line and I am going to plot here half. But we don't have to take the interval from minus infinity to infinity as we were taking in other questions. Here it is specified from minus 1 to 1. So we will plot minus 1 and 1. Now in between these two, minus 1 and 1, there are two intervals. One is minus 1, 1 divided by 2, and another one is 1 divided by 2, that is half, 1. Now in these two intervals we are going to check whether the function is increasing, decreasing, or it is not at all increasing or decreasing. So just to see, if I take any value from minus 1 to half in the function f dash x, f dash x is 2x minus 1. So suppose I take 0 in between minus 1 and half, f dash 0 will be 0 minus 1, which is negative, right? Let us check for the second interval, for this interval. From half to 1, let us take the value of x as 0.7. So f dash 0.7 will be 2 multiplied with 0.7 minus 1. What do we get? 1.4 minus 1. So we get 0.4, which is greater than 0, and it is a positive value. So just to see, in this interval, the first one, it is coming negative, that means it is decreasing here. But in the second interval, it is increasing. So in the complete function, or I say in the complete interval minus 1 to 1, we can't say the function is completely or strictly increasing or decreasing. In half of it, it is decreasing. In another half of it, it is increasing. Hence, we can say from minus 1 to 1 in this interval, the function given by f of x equals x square minus x plus 1 is neither strictly increasing nor decreasing. Let us now discuss next question. Here is your next question, question number 12. It is asked which of the following functions are decreasing on the interval 0, pi by 2. In question number 12, the first part or the first function is cos of x. So when we differentiate cos of x with respect to x, what do we get? Minus of sin x. Now, the interval given or the values of x are between 0 to pi by 2. Right? Now, between 0 to pi by 2, sin x is positive, but in front of it, just to say there is a negative sign, which is making f dash x as less than 0. So we will just write it is negative less than 0, hence it is decreasing in this interval. If we check for b part, which is cos of 2x, so I'll just write f of x as cos of 2x. Differentiating it, we get minus 2 sine of 2x. Now putting it as equal to 0, right, we can get the values of x. Also, we can see x is varying from 0 to pi by 2. So what will be the value of 2x? Multiply the inequality with 2. We get 0 less than 2x less than pi. So 2x value, that means the value of the theta here is between 0 to pi. And we know in first and second quadrant, here is first quadrant, second quadrant, 0, pi by 2 and pi. You know in the first and second quadrant, sin x is positive. Hence we are going to get positive answer from this. But just to see, it is with minus 2. So it is going to be negative or less than 0. Hence we can say this is also decreasing in this interval 0 to pi by 2. Similarly, check for C and D part of the question number 12. Clear? Let us go to next question now. Here is question number 14. We have to find out the value of a. Function given is f of x equals x square plus ax plus 1, and the interval given is 1, 2. Now differentiating it, we get it as 2x plus a. Now it is said in the question that it is increasing on this interval, right? So that means f dash x is greater than 0, right, when x belongs to 1, 2 in the close braces. So we are going to calculate f of 1, just to see what will be f of 1. So, or we can just say 2x plus a will be greater than 0 if this function is an increasing function. Now what will be f of 1? It will be 1 plus ax. Oh wait, f of 1 will be 2 into 1 plus a, which is 2 plus a, and if it is greater than 0, this implies, now solving f dash of 1, see, we will get 2 into 1 plus a, that is 2 plus a, and it will be greater than 0. So from here we get the value of a as greater than minus of 2. Similarly, if we solve f dash of 2, 1 and 2 are included here, right? So f dash 2 will be 2 into 2 plus a, which is 4 plus a, and because it is increasing, 4 plus a is greater than 0. From here we get a is greater than minus 4. Hence the function will be increasing for a greater than minus 2 and a greater than minus 4. Hence the least value will be minus of 2. Clear? दिस इज हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व क्वेश्चन नंबर 14. लेट अस गो टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 15 वी हैव टू प्रूव दैट द फंक्शन एफ गिवन बाय एक्स प्लस 1 बाय एक्स इज इंक्रीजिंग ऑन आई. आई इज एनी इंटरवल डिसजॉइंट फ्रॉम माइनस 1 टू 1. दैट मीन्स एक्सेप्ट दीज वैल्यूज विच आर इंक्लूडिंग माइनस 1 एंड 1 ऑल्सो एंड द वैल्यूज इन बिटवीन देम. एक्सेप्ट दीज वैल्यूज. अदर देन दीज वैल्यूज द फंक्शन विल बी इंक्रीजिंग. सो लेट अस जस्ट फाइंड द डेरीवेटिव ऑफ इट. द डेरीवेटिव ऑफ एक्स विल बी 1 एंड ऑफ 1 बाई एक्स इट विल बी माइनस ऑफ 1 बाई एक्स स्क्वायर. इक्वेटिंग इट टू 0 जस्ट सी वी गेट 1 इक्वल्स 1 डिवाइडेड बाई एक्स स्क्वायर और वी गेट एक्स स्क्वायर एज इक्वल टू 1. वी गेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स एज प्लस माइनस 1. टू वैल्यूज वी आर गेटिंग. नाउ प्लॉटिंग दैम ऑन द नंबर लाइन माइनस 1 1 माइनस इन्फिनिटी एंड इन्फिनिटी. सो जस्ट सी वी आर हेयर विथ थ्री डिसजॉइंट इंटरवल्स. द फर्स्ट वन इज माइनस इन्फिनिटी टू माइनस 1. द सेकेंड वन इज माइनस 1 टू 1. द थर्ड वन इज 1 टू इन्फिनिटी. नाउ जस्ट चेक माइनस इन्फिनिटी टू माइनस 1. इन दिस इंटरवल वी आर गोइंग टू पुट एनी वैल्यू इन एफ डैश एक्स विच इज 1 माइनस 1 अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर. सो एफ डैश एक्स इज 1 माइनस 1 अपॉन एक्स स्क्वायर. टेक एनी वैल्यू बिटवीन दिस इंटरवल. लेट इट बी माइनस 2. सो वी गेट 1 माइनस 1 अपॉन माइनस 2 स्क्वायर विल बी 4. वी गेट 4 माइनस 1 डिवाइडेड बाई 4 विच इज 3 बाई 4 पॉजिटिव. सो इन दिस इट इज इंक्रीजिंग. जस्ट सी इन माइनस 1 टू 1 लेट अस टेक 0. So we get, or let us take it as, if we take x as half, okay, just to see we get f dash of half as equal to 1 minus 1 upon 1 by 2 square will be 1 by 4. When we solve it, we get 1 minus 4, which is negative. So it is decreasing in this interval. And now we are going to check from 1 to infinity. Let us take x as equal to 2. So just see, we will get 1 minus 1 upon 2 square will be 4. Similar to the first part, we get 3 by 4. And this is also, it is increasing. So you just see, except minus 1 to 1, it is increasing in all the values, whether it is less than minus 1 or it is greater than 1 to infinity. So except this interval, the function is increasing in the all the intervals. Right, and this is what we had to prove. So this is how you are going to solve question number 15. Let us move to the next question. Question number 17. In this, we have to prove that the function f given by f of x equals log of modulus cos of x is decreasing on 0 comma pi by 2 and increasing on 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi. Now, in this question, just to see, we have been given log of cos x. So, our f of x is log of cos x. In the first interval, it will be positive. Now, just to see, f dash x will be log of cos x will be 1 upon cos x, and of cos x, it will be minus of sin x. Right? Now, between 0 to pi by 2, sin x is positive, cos x is positive, but because of this negative sign, we are always going to get negative answer which is less than 0, hence, it is decreasing. Clear? Now, just to see, log of cos x we have to check in this interval. Now, we know f dash x in the fourth quadrant. We have sin x is negative, so we will have negative into negative and cos x is positive. Clear? So we get the answer as positive, which is greater than 0. So in this interval, our f dash x is greater than 0, hence the function is increasing in this interval. Clear? Let us now move to the next question. So here comes question number 19. Where we have to write the interval in which the function y is equal to x square multiplied with e to the power minus x is increasing. Let us apply product rule in this and solve it. So dy by dx, or I say y dash, will be equal to x square as it is. Differentiation of e to the power minus x is e to the power minus x, and of minus x it is minus 1. Then plus e to the power minus x as it is, differentiation of x square is 2x. Now just see what we can take common in it. E to the power minus x we can take a common, clear, and x we can take common. What we are left with inside the bracket? Minus of x plus 2, clear? Now equating it to 0, just see, e to the power minus x can't be equal to 0. You put any value of x here, you will not get the answer as 0. So either x is 0 or minus x plus 2 equals 0, which shows minus x equals minus 2 and x is equal to 2. So we have these two values. Plotting them on the number line 0 and 2 from minus infinity to infinity, just to see, we have three intervals, first, second and third. We have to check in which of the interval this is an increasing function. That I think you can easily do. Just pick any value from minus infinity to 0, put in the function. Similarly, from 0 to 2, put in the function, and from 2 to infinity, you can place in the function. You just have to check whether it is coming as positive or negative. So just to see, from minus infinity to 0, if we check, let us take minus 1 as the number. So what we will get is e to the power minus 1 into minus 1 into minus, minus 1 will be plus 1 plus 2. So just to see, 1 upon e minus of 1 upon e into 3 we will get, which is a negative number less than 0. So in this it is decreasing. Now you can check for the second one, which is 0 to 2. In 0 to 2, let us take 1, right? So we will have e to the power minus 1. Here it will be plus 1 actually, not minus 1, and you are going to get 3e. Minus of 3e. So I can just replace it with minus of 3e, which is less than 0. Here you will get, if you put x as 1, we get e to the power minus 1 into 1 into minus 1 plus 2. So we get 1 divided by e into minus 1 plus 2 is 1. So 1 by e, which is greater than 0. So in 0 to 2 it is increasing. Clear? Let us check from 2 to infinity. Now in 2 to infinity, let us take 3 as the number. So just to see, e to the power minus 3 into 3 into minus of 3 plus 2. So we get 1 upon e to the power 3 will be positive. 3 is positive. Minus 1 will come. So in this it is decreasing. Yes? So the only interval in which it is increasing it, 0 to 2. Hence this will be the answer. Clear? For the homework part, you are going to complete your exercise 6.2 along with examples and come up with the doubts. Then we are going to start with new concept in the next lecture. So for more videos, do subscribe the channel and keep liking the videos. Thank you.